Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, this is Justine CHD and we are again on Tournament Desert. And this time we have in the yellow color on the bottom position as Nuke General, Live Show. And Live Show is Size. And Size is fighting against here on the top position in the pink color, Fast Spin. And Fast Spin is spawning as the USA Vanilla. And he is also known as a Peruzzi or also known as Gattuso. I will just call him a Peruzzi because this is much easier to pronounce. Okay, let's start. Normally I would say the Nuke General is just raping the USA Vanilla player. Because Nuke General is just so damn strong and USA Vanilla not so strong at all. You can go for Humvees, you can go for Paladin tanks. Paladin tanks are a very nice choice because those tanks are really amazing. But against Nuke Battlemasters or Overlords, you don't have so much, especially those Overlords. But let's see what's going on here. So Size is starting with a fast barracks into the, with direction into the middle. So he wants to take control over the middle very fast with his tank hunters to garrison the buildings. There's the first tank hunter. And he's now building up his second supply. A little bit late, but it's okay. War factory is also going up, so he is going for one war factory, one barracks, and capturing the middle. Okay, on the other side, a Peruzzi is going for one war factory and one barracks, so it looks like he's going for Humvees and filling them up with missile defenders. His two supplies are already up, and the middle also is secured by Size, so The Humvees of a Peruzzi needs to be very careful, and here is going to be a drop. I missed it, what's inside of the Chinook, but it's going to be a drop here, maybe a Humvee, or let's see. And here's the drop on the second supply, and we have a Crusader drop. Wow, that's some rare stuff to see. So a Crusader drop in a 0 hour is happening right now. Normally you don't only see this in Command Conquer Generals, but now we have it in 0 hour. So very interesting to see. Size now is countering this Crusader with his Nuke Battlemaster, but I don't think this is best decision. But as it turns out, the Nuke Battlemaster is doing more damage as than the Crusader, and this is turning out to be very good for Size. Okay, Size now has captured two oil derricks. This will boost his income a lot, and also he has the middle, so he has the free opportunity to gather resources from the middle as well. He has a Paladin tank now coming through the left side, and also in Humvee. Humvee is destroying the Battlemaster, and the Paladin tank is going to survive, and there's the Battlemaster countering this Paladin tank. Paladin tank is very hurt, but has his Hellfire drone, and it looks like he's able to destroy this Battlemaster. Here this Battlemaster is destroyed. And the Hellfire drone is picking off also this Battlemaster. What a nice action here of a Peruzzi. Another Battlemaster is going to fall to this Humvee, and the supply is going to get raped. Really rare stuff is happening here by a Peruzzi with his another drop is happening here right now with a Paladin tank. What is going on? Okay, so really, really rare stuff is happening here right now. Ooh, getting blown up by those mines. And the Paladin tank is denying any more capturing here from the resources. A Peruzzi is doing a phenomenal job at stopping his enemy here with his income. Only the oil derricks are there for the income, for Size. And there's the Paladin tank try to destroy the dozer, but this is just not enough against those five tank hunters. More Humvees are being trained by a Peruzzi, and the oil derrick is getting destroyed here by this Humvee. Really, really rare stuff happening here. All those Paladin tanks. If this wouldn't be a Nuke General, I would say we are in Generals right now. But we are not in Generals, this is a 0 hour actually. No, a bunker is going up here on the right flank, filling it up with 5 tank hunters, and this Humvee will not get through here because this bunker is just raping it. And we can now see the epic moments of this Humvee as it dies a horrible death. Now there it goes. Humvee is destroyed. Missile defenders needs to retreat. They will go into this bunker, which is a good decision. Also, Nuke Battlemaster tried to stop this, but it's just too late. And the Nuke Battlemaster shouldn't come any closer to this bunker. A nice force is now engaging through the middle. They picked off this one building. The Tank Hunter tried to do some damage, but the Paladin Tanks are very good at plinking those missiles away. Tank Hunters are dying, and here's a free dozer. Free dozer for picking off. He also approves setting up a formation. You can do this with CTRL and pressing the F button. This way we will set a formation. And we have now big overlord tanks. So I'm curious to see how Aprusi is managing to hold this off. Overlord tanks are a really big threat to those tanks here. But luckily he has missile defenders. He is also now building up his strategy center, but is still gathering from two resources and has no oil derricks. Size has one oil derrick and is gathering from two resources, so Size has the economic advantage. The ambulance tried to kill those tank hunters by driving over them and is really successfully with it. Missile defender is killing one overlord tank, but this one overlord tank seems to do some significant damage here. If this was the right word, I don't know. Ambulance here still alive with its Hellfire drone. Now the overlord tank is striking back with an ECM tank here in the back and is picking off everything here. Nice defend. Ambulance now here going at it, and it has an Hellfire drone. And here's the dozer, so we can assume what's going to happen, and the Hellfire drone is shooting. And do we see an epic action by this ambulance tank? And yes, we see it. The ambulance tank is picking off one dozer with the Hellfire drone. Really epic stuff is happening here right now. And now the Nuke Battlemaster is just going for this ambulance tank, but it was done the damage. Also, this ambulance tank doing some good damage here to this bunker. Pretty nice stuff here happening. Okay, Paladank here tried it over the left flank, but no success. Also, there's an overlord tank, so this Paladank tank really needs to watch it. Three more Humvees here by Aprusi, and the third supply is going up for capturing the resources in the middle. Very nice. Size is now training more tank hunters here to secure the middle, and also an overlord tank is messing around here in the middle. A second one is joining the party, and he has no Gatling tanks on it, so he needs to be careful that no missile defenders are raping his overlord tanks. There, one Humvee goes, a second Humvee goes, and all those Humvees are getting picked off here very easily by Size. And nice laser lock here, but this ECM tank is able to reflect all those missiles. Also, an ambulance tank is messing around here, don't know what this is going to be. And those ECM tanks are really saving the life of those overlord tanks, but this ECM tank needs to be closer to this overlord tank. Battlemaster now killing all those missile defenders. And the big attack was stopped here. And this looks very good for Size right now, because he has two big overlord tanks with an ECM tank and a Black Lotus, while Aprusi on the other hand has two Humvees and four missile defenders. But the good thing for Aprusi is that he's gathering from three resources, while Size is only gathering from two resources and has one Alderic. So it is equal with the resource income right now. Very equal here. Now we can see three overlord tanks and an ECM tank making their way here to the top. Black Lotus is spotted by the Humvee. Poor Black Lotus getting shot in the head by the Humvee. Also, Aprusi building up his command center here in the top right position. Overlord tanks are now making their way into the base. 4 Overlord tanks. And this is a very, very dangerous situation here right now for Bruzy. The garrison building getting picked off. A carp bomber is making his way into the base. And also we have an artillery strike here right now. The carp bomber destroying the strategy center. Yep, there it goes. And the artillery barely missed the supply center. But nice, A-Tables is right here. Oh, nice, picking off a lot of tanks here. That was a nice A-10 missile strike off a Prusy. The Humvees cleaning up the rest of the mess here. And one Overlord tank is getting away. But I think those Humvees are destroying not the Overlord tank. Ooh, that was close. That Humvee needs to watch it. But the Overlord tank is barely getting away. Humvee driving to it and destroying the Overlord tank, also picking off a dozer. Missile defenders laser locking the Overlord. Overlord is managed to get behind the building and is safe from those laser locking. Humvee managed to get away. Dozer cleaning those mines. And now it starts to look better for a Bruzy. He holds this attack off with a very epic A-10 missile strike and lost the Humvee there to the Overlord tank. Syce is now forced to sell one supply center because this Humvee is messing around here at the position and is also now driving to the propaganda center. This is a big loss for Syce if he's losing his propaganda center, and he is about to lose it. That was a very big loss. 3 Overlord tanks now destroying everything here, but the damage is done, and also now barely managed to survive to keep this Overlord tank alive. I mean, okay, Bruzy is now rebuilding his third supply. His second supply is already exhausted, and those Chinooks can now gather from the middle if they want to do it. A Black Lotus is manages to get through here on the left side. She wants to capture those buildings, it looks like. While another big attack of Overlord tanks is making its way to the top position. There are only 3 Paladin tanks, they cannot do anything against those Overlords. Black Lotus now here to capture the War Factory, and there's nothing around to stop her from doing this. War Factory is being sold just in time, and now those Humvees are getting back to the position, and they have spy drones on it. So Black Lotus is in big danger here, and now she will get picked off by those Humvees. There she goes. Poor life of a Black Lotus here right now. Okay, Chinook's getting picked off in the middle by a Gatling tank, and 4 more Overlord tanks are making their way into the base of a Bruzy. There's also another carpet bomber. I think we saw this scenario 5 minutes ago. Ooh, this time managed to destroy the supply center, immediately rebuilding it here. And now those Overlord tanks are a big threat for the USA player, but Bruzy has those 4 Humvees and 3 Paladin tanks, so he's not out of the game. Okay, Chinook here flying into the death zone, but luckily for him, the Gatling tank is not targeting it. Besides, there's no Gatling tank at all. Okay, now it looks like the Overlord tanks are moving in. But Bruzy is ready for the engagement. He is ready to defend this. 5 Overlord tanks and 1 ECM. This is a lot. And Bruzy really needs to be very careful. And Syce is now getting ready for it. Picking off a few buildings. Building up a Gatling cannon here in the middle. And now he is making his way in. There's another A-10 missile strike, and it's targeting the Overlord tanks. Nicely done here, killing also the dozer here. Not really killing it, but nearly destroying it. And what a nice A-10 missile strike again. And all those 5 Overlord tanks are destroyed. So this is the negative side of an ECM tank. It splits up the missiles, and this is what's happening. Mine drop here. Losing 100 to it. But what a nice defense here. The second time with a very epic 8-hit missile strike. Now the Hummies are making their way in. Abruzzi is leaving a note for him that there are mines. So he's very careful there. Another time picking off this propaganda center. And again losing it. Also now Search and Destroy is there for Abruzzi. And Sice is now losing his reactor. Two more overload tanks on the move with an ECM tank. A turret barrage destroyed this supply center. Also there are now mines on the command center. I think Abruzzi spotted them as he's driving very carefully around them. Also mines on this supply. But the War Factory is getting picked off here by those Humvees. Very good that he's doing it, and there it goes. Size is now without a production here.
Our power is low.
But he has 5,000 cash, so he is not out of the game yet. But he's now losing his oil derrick. It's of course not very good losing one Humvee here, but this was worth it. Fuel bomber here on the middle supply, picking it off, and Size is really low on buildings here right now. He's rebuilding his war factory, but he doesn't have anything left. Only this one overload, two overload tanks. This is not really a lot. Another cut bomber is making his way to the base of Abruzzi and is targeting here the supply. Yep, it is. Ooh, those are also getting picked off here. And now the two overload tanks are in the middle, sitting there, just chilling there, chilling out. While Size is rebuilding his propaganda center, he has 1,800 left. And is also now destroying a Chinook with only one tank hunter. So Chinook not very careful here, but now flying back. Okay, one Battlemaster, two overload tanks. And a fuel bomber, no, not a fuel bomber, but a leaflet drop, disabling those two overload tanks. What a nice move again here with the general promotion. Spectre gunship also picking off those overload tanks. And now Size is without anything here. He has no units. And this is going to be the GG here. While Abruzzi is now making his way into the last remaining buildings of Size. Size on 2,400, and he, it looks like he gave up everything. And there he goes, GG. Abruzzi, take the win. And that was a really, really nice match here between Size and Abruzzi. Really nice here. At the beginning I thought it was Generals I'm casting here right now, because of those Crusader drops, Paladin drops, just using only Paladin tanks and not so many Humvees. This was some really good action here by Abruzzi. I really liked it, and also Size showing off some really good actions here, but has his unlucky day and managed it to get every German promotions on his tanks and losing everything to those 8-time missile strikes and fuel bombers and whatsoever. So very nice match here between those two players. I really liked it. The only thing I didn't like is that it was on Tournament Desert, but besides that, it was a really entertaining match, and thumbs up for this replay here. A really, really cool replay. If you want to download it, it's on gamereplays.org, links description below. And also my Facebook page and my website are in the description below. Thank you for watching. This is Yasin's HD, and peace out.